Hey everyone, I'm Terry G. Thanks a lot for stopping by and watching my video. If you could take a second, can you please subscribe to my channel? I'd really appreciate it. And thanks again for stopping by. What do I want to talk about today? I want to talk about an event that happened in my life about a week ago. Those who've watched many videos of mine, you know that I have an off-the-grid cottage. And at this off-the-grid cottage, there's a neighbor who feels that he has access through my property to the lake. And I've been telling him since last year, you don't. Check it out at the register office, investigate it yourself, and you'll find out that you have no access. So the other day he comes over and he tells me that I put a chain up on my driveway, and because I block him, he's gonna block my roadway and not allow me into my cottage, which is totally bogus. But anyways, he said it. And then what happened, I totally lost it on him. You know, I've been in sobriety for 28 years, and here's me losing it on some guy. I am 6'1", 210 pounds. He's about 5 feet tall, about 140 pounds. And I gave it to him with both barrels. I call him an effing prick. You want a war, you got a war. You know, I'm like, what the hell are you saying, Terry? You know, what are you, Al Pacino and Scarface? You want a war? I'm gonna give you a war. Well, let me tell you, it did not feel good. And like I said, I gave it to him with both barrels. The anger came up and it scared the living hell out of him. And you know, I've been in sobriety, like I said, for 28 years. And that behavior, when it shows its ugly face or when it happens within me, how bad I feel. I was in the right, believe me. But the way I handled it was wrong. And some people will disagree with me. But the way I was wrong is the way I acted. Angrily, I scared the guy, nothing got accomplished, nothing got settled, and I felt like a jerk. And when you're in sobriety and you do things like that, that go against your moral compass or things that you've been working on for many years, it really is a major setback. It really is. It feels really bad. And that's what I'm trying to get at in this video, is that we are not perfect. There are parts of us will always need work, will always need to watch. And for me, that is anger. My sweetheart was standing right beside me and she says, Terry, I've never seen you like that. And she's been with me for a number of years. And she says, you don't have an anger issue. But at that very time, I felt like I did have an anger issue. All those old behaviors, all those old ways that I was thinking came back to me again and said, Terry, you screwed up. After all this time, after all this therapy, after all this service work, helping others, you screwed up. You can't control your anger after all these years. And you know, that went on for about a week. I had an emotional relapse, as they call it, for about a week. I was unable to forgive myself and just think about the situation rationally and try and resolve it within myself. I talked to members of the program. I talked to a lot of people. I prayed, I asked for forgiveness, all those things. But you know something? I am not perfect. I do not go around harming people. That's the last thing on my mind. And I consider myself, you know, pretty good sobriety. But sometimes our sobriety might look like hell. It might not look that great and make us feel that great in our daily lives. But how we treat ourselves when things are bad, or we get down on ourselves, or life isn't going good, or we're not acting properly, is just as important as how we treat ourselves when things are going good for us. It's easy to treat ourselves well when things are going good, but sobriety is a journey. The road to recovery is always under construction. We are not perfect. There's parts of us and there's parts of me that need to be watched. Character defects, old behaviors, old way of thinking. I need to keep watching that. And that's what going to meetings are about. That's what talking to people in the programs are about. Reaching out, not keeping things to yourself, letting those feelings out, talking about the way you think, bouncing it off of your friends, on and on. There's lots of support I have, and I hope you have lots of support, because when these events happen in our sobriety, can make us feel very lonely and make us feel like an island. Anger is a natural feeling. It's a feeling of change. It's a feeling that tells us something is wrong. But but sometimes it gets out of hand in my life, and I don't like it. I really, really don't like it. I've spent many years in therapy dealing with anger. I've talked about it, and every time I go around anger or express anger inappropriately, I get these emotional hangovers. But thanks to my friends, my higher power, my sweetheart, my support network, that I don't have to beat the shit out of myself and continue to believe that I'm an angry SOB, because I'm not. I've seen my neighbor, he's come over and talked to me. We've figured out the situation. I've made my amends, saying it won't happen again, and it's left alone. Thanks to the program, I have the ability to look after those situations. So the name of this video is I'm Not Perfect. I do the best I can on a daily basis, and recovery is a journey. And like I said, it's always under construction. I could keep going on about it. This is my new section on my channel. It's called That's Life. I want to talk about true events that happened to me in my life, not all negative, but some of them will be negative, and how I dealt with them with the program of recovery. And I think it's really, really important, that is, okay? So thanks a lot for stopping by. This is an angry channel. This is an alcohol-free life channel where we learn to be sober one day at a time. And just, you know, take it one day at a time. Go easy on yourself, love yourself, treat yourself well, and be good to yourself. Become your own best friend, okay? My name is Terry G. Thanks a lot for stopping by. If you could take a second, can you please smash that subscribe button and hit that like button? I'd really appreciate it. And I'll see you next time. It's a long weekend coming up, and guess where I'm going? I'm going to my off-the-grid cottage, where everything is peaceful and it's beautiful up there. And I love being there. I love being there. Thanks for stopping by. Ciao for now. Keep it real, keep it safe, and stay sober. Bye-bye.